video calling. Not exactly the breakthrough announcement we expected when Apple unveiled the iPhone 4. But then Apple has a knack for making things catch on, so it's decided to have a go at making video calls work.
And that's where this little VGA camera on the front comes into play.
Of course, video calling's been around for years, but it's always been a sort of a third wheel feature.
Not to mention costing an arm and a leg in data charges. But with FaceTime, it's only operating over Wi-Fi, so you can make face-to-face calls without taking a chunk out of your tariff.
Problem is, at the moment, it's only over Wi-Fi, and only available to other iPhone 4 users. Not exactly the most convenient of things. Unless you carry around a Wi-Fi in your pocket, you'll have to always be in range of a hotspot.
Jimmy, I'm just losing Wi-Fi. What is convenient is that you can FaceTime anyone who's got an iPhone 4 on Wi-Fi. There's no account to set up and no fiddling around with settings. And that's what Apple brings to the equation.
That's true. You can literally get face-to-face with people at the tap of a button. And we can see this being lapped up by teenagers wanting to talk to mates, travelling businessmen wanting to keep in touch. And if the gushy advert is anything to go by, people wanted to share that special moment with friends and family. Okay, they might not all have iPhone 4s yet, but after shifting nearly 2 million units in 3 days after launch, odds are a fair majority of your phone book soon will.
The other nice thing about FaceTime is you're not just restricted to this front-facing camera. If you pop this button down here, you can switch it to the rear camera and even change into horizontal view so your caller can see what you're seeing.
Apple has carefully chosen their words by saying FaceTime over 2010, meaning that in 2011 it may be available on 3G. In fact, they even mentioned that it's up to the carriers themselves to offer it. When asked whether FaceTime will be available on 3G, 3GS or even other manufacturers' mobiles, there wasn't a conclusive no from Apple there either. So the fact that it's on iPhone 4 only shouldn't have to hold you back in the future.
So FaceTime isn't perfect. If you're on a flaky Wi-Fi connection, it can be a bit choppy. But otherwise, video and audio quality is pretty good. It's exactly that quality and simplicity that Apple are likely to be safeguarding by making it Wi-Fi only. So, particularly considering it's free, it's certainly not a bad start.